because I don't have anything else better to do and that there's no one else around here, let's go for a quick walk around the station building. So this is the platform 2 side. Really not much here, to be honest. There's no seat undercover seating on this section of the platform. This is the sort of station entrance area. There's your My Key machine. The old ticket window back in the day would have been about there. There's the exit ramp that goes to the pedestrian crossing outside the station. Looking towards the city, and this is the platform 1 side. Passenger information display up there. Go for another little quick wander. Some seating on this side, but really not much, to be honest, and the station building is quite small as well, so not much weather protection here. Back on the other side, but if you go here, there is a small ramp in between the two platforms. You do have this small undercover waiting area here where you will find some more seating. Undercover nevertheless, under the shade, but again, not really much. Ringwood East is a fairly basic station. Now all the station announcements say, please stand behind the yellow line. Well, what yellow line? There literally isn't one here. It's completely faded away. Can't see it at all.
Thank you. please don't park here. We have the community market on today and we need all the car parking spaces. Yeah, nah, there's definitely no market here on today. I think it might have got canned.
Thank you.
senior level crossing boom gates and the pedestrian boom gates go up and down in sync. Absolute perfection. This is starting to turn into the Donnybrook video again. I was filming trains at the level crossing there and I saw nothing but fire trucks, and so far today I've seen an ambulance and another fire truck, so who knows, I might see some more fire trucks. So I'm just waiting to film the next train at level crossing, and over here I noticed there's some Public Transport Corporation signage. This is property of the Public Transport Corporation. Damage or misuse of this property will incur a fine of up to 10 years imprisonment. And look at this, it's the old Met symbol. I must say the Dublin Road level crossing is a great level crossing to film at, partly because you get very good views of the rail corridor on either side, you've got some very interesting equipment with the MIDI pedestrian boom gates, but the other thing as well is that the level crossing, apart from the flashing lights and the big boom gates, it's also protected by some traffic lights. So none of the cars, when a train comes through, they're not actually waiting at the level crossing, they're actually waiting at the traffic lights, which means you can get clear, unobstructed views of trains as they pass over the level crossing. This has now become one of my favourite level crossings in Melbourne to film at. In fact, if this level crossing had a hybrid bell instead of the e-bells, it would be absolute perfection. You could not get any better than this. Thank you. The good thing about the traffic lights at this level crossing as well, they start going red just before the level crossing activates. So on the other side of the road here, we got an amber light and a red light. And you know, when those sequences start going from amber to red, you know the level crossing is about to activate. It's probably a good thing that I'm getting some clips recorded from this gravel car park here, because according to this sign here, this car park is closing on Tuesday the 7th of February, which is only 3 days from now. So it definitely seems like works will be ramping up here fairly shortly. It looks like I got here just in time. I'm about to wrap up the video now here at Ringwood East, but I must say, I was pleasantly surprised on just how good this station is for rail fanning. Even if you're only interested in just filming metro trains, just X'trapolis 100 trains, there are plenty of trackside spots around the station that you can get clips from. such as all the pedestrian crossings, the Dublin Road level crossing, and there's a couple of other vantage points around the station as well. I was pleasantly surprised. Well, I must say though, you have to enjoy it while it lasts, because this is all going to be gone in about 2 years. Thank you.